Hey everyone, we're off exploring again today, so if you want to come along, you can come along. We are off to a lake that we've only been to one time before, and it was pretty much a year ago. Went there, a friend took us there on the dirt bike, and it's quite wilderness. There's going to be no cell reception, there's no one living close by at all, so it's like the first time I've actually let someone know where I'm going, and I've packed food and made sure I had matches along and that sort of thing. I've just being safe, I guess. It wouldn't take me nearly a day to walk out of here. And I got the three kids along, so I'll turn you around and you can see where we're going. It's a gravel road. It's a beautiful day. Also a year ago, this friend and I came along this road and cut some really tall trees down. The trees were coming right up to the road like they are on the one side, but they cleared this other side. But they left a few tall trees, like big grandmothers and grandfathers, and they died. So we got a permit, well he got a permit, and we came down here and cut them, made firewood out of it. to the left, that is a Native American reservation. And we are going to proceed at our own risk to the lake. There was a mine here. Up here in the north, it's very rich in minerals. And there's been mines all over the place here, so there's a mine by Namu Lake, that's where I'm going. I don't know how to say it properly. And we passed Chocolate Lake, there was a mine there too, and apparently Chocolate Lake is contaminated. This lake here has hagstones, which is, this lake is beautiful. It is absolutely breathtakingly beautiful. But I also really wanted to go here to collect some hagstones. Those are the stones that have holes in them. I'm not very adventuresome when it comes to being out and about on my own. I much prefer to have an exploring partner, but being brave, I'm being brave. So the mine here, I don't know how long ago it was, but there's nothing left of it anymore other than the shafts that have been capped. So I will show you. I will show you them. Just a big square concrete block. doesn't seem right. I don't want to get lost here. I will pause you and I'll go out and see what I can see. I parked the truck, leashed up the kids, well, collared them up. I'm gonna go down here and see. I don't think this is right, but you never know. Here's a big slab of, this is what I was talking about, but they were, the ones that I saw last year were like flat on the ground because they were capping off a shaft, tunnel shaft. And there were signs as well. This is definitely not where we went, so I'm going to turn around and get back into the truck. I saw this exact same thing in the clouds yesterday. And I also saw a crossroads in the clouds yesterday. So me being me, I'm going to see if I can get the stone person out and take it back with me. This stone person is not going to go with me because it's like all over here. It's really big. So it just wanted to me to see. So thank you, thank you, thank you. I got some other good stuff though. I'll show you guys later. I need to wash them off because they're part of the road. All right, off to look for the lake some more. Hey, no lake yet, but look what I found, you guys. Can you see? Oh, it's amazing. It is just absolutely amazing. Just laying on top of the earth. Oh, I'm so excited. So I was turning around to go back from where I happened to glance over my shoulder. And there is a yellow sign there that I'm going to go check out because that is the kind of sign that we drove past when we were here last time. Let's see if Hep's gonna come out. Okay, Hep. Come on, let's go. I'm surprised that this isn't a well-traveled path here if this is going to the lake because... Yeah, it seems that people would go fishing here and perhaps even launch boats, so I can't quite remember. So, we'll go check this out. Oh, you know what? That looks like there's a lake there. Oh, there's a bunch of sandhill cranes behind me. Oh. All right, off we go. Oh yeah, there we go. There's the lake. Okay, I'll zoom you guys in so you can see. Yeah. Okay. We have a riven. Well, we've a riven somewheres. I think we've a riven where we want to go. Haven't seen any gentians yet. Can't remember if I saw them here last year or not. Might be too far north. Oh yeah, here we go. Alright. Caution, mineshaft, bulkhead. Oh man, I'm so glad that I glanced over my shoulder and saw this. So that's where the mine bulkhead was, and then there's another one over here. Oh, the sun is shining. I can't see what you see. Wow. Wonder how far down it goes. Makes me want to you know what? I'll just back right off and I'll go sit at the lake instead. I've had enough adventures for today, going into the wilderness and not being able to find the lake. So we don't want to fall down into a mine shaft today. As fun as that might be, but probably not. Boys have never been here because I was here on a dirt bike. So this is new for them. Left the floof behind. He's starting to explore a little bit more and not stay with us. So not sure if we really want to keep taking him into the forest or not. At Rocky Lake I still would. Because I live right close by, so I could just, you know, go back and get him. I don't know. I know not. Oh, okay. There's a well-traveled road, so we just didn't come down the right road. Well, that's all right. We'll know for next time. Yeah, because this is a well-traveled road, so people do come down here. I was sure there was a well-traveled road. Oh, look at that! Oh, isn't it just the best walking around a corner and seeing a lake? Oh. Wow. This is where I want to live, guys. No people, no electricity, no sounds, no artificial sounds other than like airplanes. As far as I know, there's not a single person that lives on this lake. And it's big. It's big, big. All this ground up rock must be from the mine. Ooh, I'm gonna have fun! Oh, I haven't giggled like this in a long time. Oh man. Oh man. Oh, this one's pretty. I like the ones with the white and the pink. No, that's not the one. Where are we here? This one. Are you zoomed in or something? Something's funky with my camera here. A little bit of rust. These are not the rocks that I were talking about. I don't know if these look like they were probably brought in here. Perhaps. The rocks that I were talking about are over here. I will show you. No, I've got a swimmer. Hey, Miss Foxy. Good times? Ooh, here's a rock, or a heart, I mean, a big heart. Look at that. Look at that. That might come back with me. Oh, I'll put it on top of here so I see it later. When we were here on the dirt bike, it was already colder. So, I had on a snowmobile suit. And then I started finding hag rocks. I stuffed myself full. My friend was like, we'll come back for them. And I said, no, who knows? And we never did. So I'm very glad that I stuffed them. And I found my big house rock, my big house stone person with like an attic window and another window. Look at this. Isn't that just amazing? Isn't that just amazing? Here's one. This is what I'm talking about. A hagstone. This one has two holes in it. I know that in, oh, I'm having a brain fart. If it comes to me, I'll tell you. If it doesn't, I won't. It wasn't important. Oh, here's another heart. Hey, Hap, what do you think? You want to move here? And then every once in a while, there's a rock with color, but mainly they're just the... I'm guessing this must be limestone. looks like petrified poop. Oh, there's a flock of geese, I guess. I don't know. Why do they sound a little different than geese? I'm not sure. They almost sound more like the cranes. The cranes have a very unique, I don't know how you describe it, a garbling sound almost. Gargling, garbling. This rock looks like someone threw acid on it and it just got eaten away. And it's quite far down. Oh, I hear Hep barking. I don't think he wants to come here. And like, look at this. It's like a deep hole. Definitely not a place to go walking along bare feet. So, what do you think? Perfect for a little blue-eyed Molly retreat center, hey? Oh, there's Hap. Hey, Hap! Boating, fishing, sitting, hiking trails. Oh! Oh, oh! Bald eagle, you guys. Goodness, the stage just got so much better. Huh. Well then. Where was I? I don't think it even matters anymore. Oh. I am just feeling so happy and overwhelmed right now to be able to come to places like this. And I'm so grateful that I'm able to share them with you too, for those of you who aren't able to leave the city or just don't have water around you or don't have wilderness around you or just aren't able for whatever reason. My heart's bursting right now. Thanks for joining me.